Occasionally, I'll hear of some fears and worries of computer science courses. And well, that's quite understandable because a lot of people going into computer science are quite fresh to the concept. So naturally, doing a degree in that particular area would be quite a daunting idea. Well, I happen to be a computer science student. In fact, I'm nearly done with getting my degree. I have done 3.5 years of work and I'm going towards my final semester. So I thought I'll talk a little bit about, you know, the experience as a computer science student. I'll try to answer some common questions, you know, FAQ style. Hopefully this would be a good chance for me to reflect on my own experiences, and if it helps you, then all the better. You're watching another Random Wednesday episode on 0612 TV. Hello and welcome back to another Random Wednesday episode. Now, let's set the scene. As mentioned earlier, I am a 4th year computer science student about to graduate. I study in the National University of Singapore and I'm working towards getting a bachelor's with honours in computer science. My focus areas are visual computing and interactive media. So what this means is I spend a lot of my time in graphics and media related areas, but as a computer science student. So what that means, we'll get into that later. Now, I think I should preface this with a note that I didn't actually take on a lot of the opportunities provided by the school. That is, I didn't actually go for any exchange programs, I didn't do an internship, I didn't even join any events or any clubs. I have performed some teaching duties as a student TA before, but that's about it. That's about all the extra stuff I've done. While I'd like to say that, you know, the reason for doing this is because I want to focus entirely on my studies, you know, all that theoretical stuff is what I do best, really the truth is just I'm kind of the awkward nerd type, so I don't really hang around with people a lot. I prefer to stick around with my devices, and really I think that's okay. At any rate, the point is it is important to note that I'm really talking mostly in a context of the lessons. Anyway, with that said, let us begin. Let us tackle this in a question and answer style. First, what do you do? Good question. What do I do as a computer science student? Now, in our university, we're allowed to pick whatever modules we like, of course with certain restrictions, but the point being that, you know, the order in which things happen are not very well defined. They depend on how you decide to schedule your timetable. But there is still a general order there, which of course makes sense. We start by learning how to write code, and that is of course a crash course in both coding skills as well as the concept of algorithms, so that serves as the very fundamental of our course. After that, we begin to branch out. We begin to look at, you know, individual areas in computer science like security, like networking, operating systems, you know, algorithms, hardware, that kind of stuff. At the same time, we also have focus on software engineering. That is, of course, giving us exposure to, you know, working on projects in the real world. The emphasis there is actually in good coding practices. So in fact, that eclipses the basic learning how to code part of things very quickly. You'll find that the emphasis shifts very quickly away from writing a program that works, towards writing a program that is readable, writing a program that is maintainable. So yeah, these are the things you have to do as a computer scientist in the future. Past this stage, we go ahead and specialize in a particular area. As mentioned, my specialization would be towards graphics and media. So yeah, I do a lot of that in the later years. Question 2. Is there a lot of math in computer science? Now, this is actually one of my burning questions as well, right before I actually entered computer science. And the reason, of course, is that I'm terrible at math. You should see my math grades. They are easily the worst looking grades that I've gotten in my entire uni life. Anyway, that's not the point. I know a lot of people are concerned about this, probably for a similar reason. Any answer to this question is, it depends. If this question was, is there math in computer science, then the answer is a resounding yes. You cannot escape from basic math in general computer science. But the good news is, most of it isn't difficult. For example, to be able to properly analyze how long an algorithm runs, you will need some math knowledge to do so. Luckily, this is generally very simple math, At the end of the day, you are a computer science student, not a math student. So yeah, basically, the math stuff isn't there to kill you. The math stuff is just a tool to help you in doing computer science. Of course, the answer to the question is it depends. And the reason for that is depending on what you specialize in, you may actually set yourself up for a lot of complex math. For example, I know people who are doing artificial intelligence. All that machine learning stuff is all math. In fact, a lot of it is advanced statistics. So yeah, that is the reason why I did not pick that area of specialization. It's just over my head. Graphics has its fair share of math as well, but I don't think it's complex in the sense that a lot of it is just matrix manipulations, so I'm still not in a very bad place. It's a different story when I did computer vision. There was a lot of math and very little intuition, so I did struggle and I did end up with not a very good grade. So yeah, the bottom line is it depends. If you want to get into a particular specialization, ask around and make sure you know what you're signing up for. Question 3. Do I need to have a good programming background? Of course, this is a concern for a lot of people who are going fresh into computer science. If your university is anything like mine, you don't have anything to worry about because that is what they're prepared for. For many people, this is their first exposure to computer science, so the university knows to start from scratch and build up from there. Of course, having said that, having a background is great. If you haven't started your degree just yet and you want to be well prepared for it, then start learning about some basic concepts. I'm not saying you need to know how to program, but what is most important in computer science is to sort of get your mindset correct. I guess to understand how computers and algorithms work, you have to think in a particular way. So yeah, once you grab onto that intuition, you have something to move on with. Of course, having said that, well, I must mention the other side of the story as well. Having some background might be detrimental. I've been programming for many years before I started doing any formal education in computer science, and what I find is that I'd built up a lot of bad practices that I then had to learn to break. But yeah, it's a double-edged sword. You may find yourself having to unlearn some things. Of course, then again, in computer science, there is a lot of unlearning involved. So yeah, be prepared for that as well. Question 4 naturally follows from question 3, and that is, if I don't have a background, how can I cope? I think I should preface this by giving you a bit of mental preparation for what's to come. Chances are your first semester will be quite intense. After all, you do have a limited time to learn the ropes, in the sense that not only do you have to learn to program, you also have to learn to think in a correct way. And at the same time, you're also bombarded by the other modules you are taking. Of course, don't let that discourage you. Like I said, you are in the same boat with a lot of other people, and resources are always available when you need them. Go to your professors, go to your tutors, don't be afraid to ask for help. I mean, as a tutor myself, I've told them that, you know, I'm paid to do this, so ask for help. Don't suffer in silence. What we have in our school are also, you know, student unions and clubs that actually organize more events to help you. So yeah, if you're in need of help, sign up to these events. Basically, just get as much help as you can from the people around you. Of course, another thing you could do would be like what I mentioned just now for the previous question. If you haven't started on your degree just yet and you'd like to get a head start, now's the time to start picking up things, start learning concepts, start maybe doing a simple programming language. Question 5. I'm not good at programming, or I dislike programming. Would this be a problem? Once again, the answer to this is it depends. Programming is a huge part of a computer science degree, so yeah, it's not going to be something you can avoid. If you really dislike it, or if you have huge problems wrapping your head around it, then unfortunately, maybe a computer science degree is not for you. If you're still interested in computing in general, then consider other courses. Consider looking at courses that are computing related, but perhaps they put a business spin on it. So that would basically reduce the amount of programming you have to do. Once again, you can't avoid it entirely, but if you take a course like that, chances are the emphasis is elsewhere, so you have a better time. Of course, don't judge too early. Chances are, over time, you'll get better. Sometimes, it's not that something is hard, it's just you need more time to get used to it. So yeah, it would probably be a good idea to hang around for a while and, you know, if you decide to go elsewhere, make sure that it is a justified decision. Oh, and don't be discouraged if self-study doesn't quite work out for you. Computer science is a very huge field. It's not easy to self-learn things and do it very well. School is much better for this, because after all, you are surrounded by experts, and they, well, will try to present things in a way that is easier to understand. Question 6. Why are topics like graphics and media part of a computer science course? Surely they would be more appropriate under, say, art. This is a common misconception that comes up from time to time. What we are doing is not using graphics software. Instead, we're learning the algorithms that drive them. I did do a filmmaking course that was probably the least computer science-y of computer science courses I've taken, but even that actually went into some technical subjects, things like compression, things like color spaces. So yeah, basically, if you take a course under the computer science faculty, chances are you will be doing some amount of computer science in there. Question 7. Why am I made to do X thing when it has already been implemented by other people? This comes up a lot, especially when we were doing, you know, basic data structures and algorithms. Why do we need to implement, say, a stack when Java already has a stack data structure? The reason for this is to exercise your understanding of a subject. Chances are many of the things you've learned are already available. So if all you need to do is to use what is already available, you don't learn very much. So yeah, that is the reason why. In fact, I understand sometimes it gets really daunting because you're trying to implement this thing that makes no sense. But a good thing about this is that if it is a known data structure, then chances are you can find more help online. Of course, I'm not asking you to copy code you find online. Even though you can find code online and you can copy it if you really want to, but don't, because it defeats the purpose of the exercise. Question 8. How do I do well in computer science? That is not an easy question to answer, but at the same time, it is not impossible, so I'll try and do what I can. First of all, I think what makes things the most easy to understand is the fact that I can get an intuitive understanding of things. Now, the unfortunate truth is that a professor isn't always going to present the most intuitive thing to you first. I mean, this depends entirely on their teaching style. But I think knowing what to focus on, at least at the beginning, is helpful. For example, some things may be presented to you as both a concept as well as supporting code at the same time. The best thing to do would be to focus on the concept first. What I like to do is to be able to paint a picture first. In fact, try this as a test. Basically, pick an algorithm or pick a concept and explain it in plain English. Do not make reference to the code. In fact, try to shy away from implementation-specific details. Just talk about things at a high level. Describe what happens. If you are able to do that, then you have a good understanding of the concept at hand. You'll be surprised how hard that can be. Sometimes you are just so used to thinking about things in terms of the code that you don't actually, you know, really know what the algorithm is doing. If you put too much emphasis on the code, you run the risk of just memorizing the code. So yeah, the emphasis is on painting a picture. You have to understand a concept as a concept, not as code. When it comes to programming, how do you do well in programming? Well, I think what a lot of people are grappling with is the concept that failure is okay. Of course, we hate it when the compiler gives us some error and refuses to run our code, but that is not a failure. That is a learning experience. I know it sounds corny, but it's true, because a lot of the time, the compiler is telling you something meaningful. While it might be frustrating at first, I think it is very important to learn how to listen to your compiler and learn from the errors it's giving you. After all, at the end of the day, what you're taking away from writing code is how you adapt your thinking to match that of a computer's. And that is naturally a slow process, but the more code you write, the better you'll get at it. In fact, what I do is I do a lot of coding for fun on the side. The best thing that can happen is that you're passionate about computers. you want to actually write code, you know, just to see how things work or to solve a particular problem. And in doing that, you actually give yourself an opportunity to code more. The more you code, the more you are exposed to, you know, interactions with a computer and interactions with a compiler. And that, of course, is more opportunities to learn. So yeah, don't be afraid to do some programming on the side for fun. While I found that assignments, you know, issued by the school are generally useful and enough most of the time, that might not be the case for you. If you find that that isn't enough and you want to be able to do more, then seek out your own opportunities for practice. What you'll find is that over time, you'll be able to get more used to it, you'll be able to write things that work correctly on the first time. So yeah, that is where you learn. And that, ladies and gentlemen, were 8 questions that I hear asked very often. Now, answer. Well, at least those were my perspective on them. If you talk to someone else, they may give you somewhat different answers. However, based on my observation, it seems that what I've discussed here works generally well for a lot of people. So yeah, don't be afraid to try that. Now, if you are a new computer science student or prospective computer science student and I haven't addressed your query today, please do leave a comment below and I'll do my best to help you. That's all there is for this episode. Thank you very much for watching, and until next time, you're watching 0612 TV. Thank you very much for watching. If you like this video, consider checking out the rest of my work on my channel. Alternatively, you may be interested in my other vlogs. If you'd like to show me some monetary support, I am on Patreon. You can find a link to my campaign in the video description. Of course, you can simply like this video or leave a comment. I'll be sure to respond as soon as I can. To keep in touch with my future uploads, do subscribe to this channel. And for even more updates, check out the official Twitter account for this channel at 0612TV. Thank you for your support.